Accuracy in Valorant is super important to hit nice crispy headshots, but if your sensitivity isn't quite right, you might end up missing some crucial shots. What's up guys, Defied here and welcome to the channel. Last time I took you through a training routine to help improve your aim, which so far has helped over 200,000 people, which is pretty crazy. Today we're going to take that a step further by helping you find your best mouse sensitivity. We'll go through that in just a sec, but first we need to double check some settings that might negatively impact your consistency. Alright guys, so the first settings we're going to look at here are your pointer options in Windows. There's a few ways you can do this. The best way, or the easiest way that I find, is to go to the search menu here, or press the start button or your Windows key on your keyboard, and just type in pointer, and then open up this first option here, change the mouse pointer speed. And you've got this section here come up, select a pointer speed. So here you want to basically make sure that your mouse speed is in the middle, which is the sixth option out of 11. You can change it slower and faster, but you want it right in the middle there. And then enhance pointer precision, make sure that's switched off. That's basically mouse acceleration. So some people say that this is disabled by games anyway, but I prefer to be safe than sorry. So go ahead, switch that off, then hit apply, okay. And if you've got a gaming mouse, I've got a Logitech G Pro Wireless. So there's often software that they'll have for these mice. So mine's the Logitech G Hub. So if you've got something like this gaming software for your mouse, go ahead and open that up. And then look for your sensitivity DPI settings. So here, you basically want to set your DPI to something that you're comfortable with in Windows. It will affect your in-game sensitivity as well, but we're going to essentially be changing your in-game sensitivity in Valorant, so it's not going to matter too much what you choose here. Just something comfortable with in Windows is good. I choose 800 DPI. You can choose 800 if you want. And then also you want to look for your report rate or polling rate. So this is basically how much information or how quickly information is sent to your computer from your mouse. A higher number is better here. So make sure you've got the highest option selected. Mine's 1000. Now the last thing you want to look for here is something called angle snapping. And not every mouse has it, but essentially what it tries to do is move your mouse in a straight line, even if you're not moving the mouse in a straight line. So you definitely want to switch this off if you can find it. An often overlooked component of consistent, good aim actually comes from your desk setup and posture. If you have poor posture that seems to change a lot, then it's likely that your consistency will be low, since your muscle memory will be slightly different in every position. But when you get into a good habit of using the same posture and desk setup, your muscle memory will remember what to do and you'll see improvement a lot quicker. Overall, you need to have a good desk setup and posture that feels moderately relaxed and comfortable. So the first thing to look at here is your arm position and pivot point. This will differ from person to person, as it really depends on your preferred playstyle and what feels comfortable for you. For example, a player with low sensitivity will most likely be different from a player with high sensitivity. The pivot point is the point where your arm contacts the desk and where you rotate or pivot from when moving the mouse. You can pivot from anywhere between your wrist and your elbow, but generally someone with lower sensitivity will pivot closer to the elbow so that they can move the mouse further when they need to. Now to find what works best for you will take a little bit of trial and error, but try to find a position with your arm on the desk that feels comfortable when moving the mouse. For me, I use quite low sensitivity and a lot of desk space, so I rest almost my whole arm on the desk so that my pivot point is just before my elbow. Most of the time, I'll use my wrist and small arm movements for accurate shots, but if I need to perform a quick movement or far flick, I can pivot from my forearm and hit the shot. Another part of the setup is also your mouse grip. Now I'm just going to do a quick rundown on this, but there are lots of different ways to hold your mouse. The main styles here are palm grip, claw grip, and fingertip grip, among others. A lot of professionals have some crazy grip styles, and I really don't recommend copying what they do unless it feels comfortable for you. I tried using a claw grip for a while because that's what Shroud uses, but honestly it didn't work for me. I'm much better off with a relaxed fingertip grip as I find it very comfortable, but also I can perform quicker movements with this style. The main thing I found here is work with what feels most comfortable for you. Feel free to try the different grips out, but decide on the best one quickly and then stick with it. Now the last thing I want to mention on setup before we get into the sensitivity method is to make sure your desk is clear of clutter and that you have enough space. Now of course this isn't always going to be possible, but you can't expect to be consistent if you've got a dinner plate, some Lego and a Red Bull on your mouse pad. Of course, if you keep hitting your keyboard or monitor mount with your mouse, then that's a good sign that your setup isn't quite right. So try to make yourself some extra space if you can. Alright guys, finally we're going to go through the sensitivity method, and what I'm going to show you is called the Perfect Sensitivity Approximation Method, or PSA method for short. Now, there's a few ways you can do this. I think the best way is in Valorant itself. So go ahead, launch the game and open up a training session. And basically the first thing we're going to do here is a 360 from one side of your mouse pad to the other. Even if your mouse pad is enormous, this method will still work, but you might need to reduce the movement range to a full movement of your arm from your pivot point. Alright, so put your mouse onto the very edge of your mouse pad and move it across to the very edge of the other side. Adjust your sensitivity and then keep repeating this action until you get a perfect 360 from one side of the mouse pad to the other. This is going to be your starting sensitivity. Now, you'll need to do some calculations to work all of this out, but don't worry because I've made this really easy for you. So in the description, you'll find a link similar to this. It'll be probably a little bit further down the page, but if you click on this link, you'll open up my website where I've put this calculator here for you, so you don't have to do the calculations. Now, this will come up, the screen will come up, and you'll essentially want to put your starting sensitivity in here, which we did just before. Mine was 0.38, and then your starting DPI as well. Mine was 800. You don't have to put the DPI in, but it's useful if you want to get your eDPI or equivalent DPI value to compare against other people's sensitivities later. Don't have to, but you can if you want. Now you'll also see here you've got a number of iterations that we're going to go through, and we've got a value for a lower sensitivity, a higher sensitivity over here, your average sensitivity, which is the average of the lower and the higher, which is your starting sensitivity at the moment, and eDPI values. We've also got a preference column here with a drop down, which has two options of lower or higher. Have a look at what's shown in the lower option, then head back into Valorant and set your in-game sensitivity to that value. Now you need to test this out, so set up some static bots, and your task is to use this new sensitivity to move around while trying to track the bot's head as best as you can. Try lots of different movements here, side to side, up close and far away. Even try jumping at different distances and still track the bot's head. The idea is to be able to follow the target accurately and without jitters at a variety of ranges. You can add elevation changes too if you want, but do this training for at least 2 minutes or however long you need to get a feel for it. Once you're done with the lower option, go ahead and change your sensitivity to the value shown in the higher option and repeat the exact same thing in the training area. Once you're done with the higher sensitivity, you need to decide which one felt better. Think about which one felt easier, but also consider the smoothness, any jitters or issues that you had up close or at far range. Head back over to the calculator and enter the one that felt better into the preference column. At the start, they're probably both going to feel pretty far away from your ideal sensitivity, but that's okay because we are going to repeat the whole process 7 times. Each time will feel a little bit better, and the difference between lower and higher will be harder to gauge. As you get towards the last iteration, you might even need to repeat the same sensitivities a couple of times to decide which one felt best. Alright, so once you get to your 7th iteration and you go ahead and put your final preference in the column here, your perfect sensitivity is shown as well as your equivalent eDPI value there. So go back into Valorant, put your perfect sensitivity in, and you're all set, you're ready to go. For those of you who want to know, I use 0.23 sensitivity. I actually got rid of the one on the end because you don't really need it. And that's on 800 DPI, and my eDPI for that is 184. Some of you might notice that Valorant also gives you the option to change the scope sensitivity multiplier for whatever reason, but I'd advise to leave this at 1. Why? Well, it's based on your mouse sensitivity already, and putting a multiplier in here basically changes your sensitivity whenever you scope in, making training and building muscle memory more difficult. If you really feel you need to change this, then feel free, but I definitely advise the majority of you should keep this at 1. After you've set your sensitivity and start using it, it should feel pretty natural, but sometimes you're gonna miss your shots. When this happens, I urge you not to change your sensitivity to compensate for this. The reason for this is because every time you change, you are basically confusing your muscle memory and reflexes, and you've got to learn them all over again. The best thing to do here is to use your sensitivity and practice with it in order to build consistency and muscle memory. I've put a link in the description to the aim practice guide I created, which you can use to really improve your aim and muscle memory, if you haven't seen it already, of course. That guide will really help to build your muscle memory, but just remember that there are many other factors which you need to practice. For example, just being familiar with the different guns in Valorant can really help you improve as well. So take some time to go into the range and test out the different weapons. Anyway, if you just stick with your chosen sensitivity and really practice with it, I'm sure that you'll find that you'll improve quite quickly. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I really hope you've found this video useful and it will help you to find your best mouse sensitivity. Now, if it does, please like the video and consider subscribing with notifications on. All that stuff helps me out, helps me grow the channel, and helps me to keep making these videos for you guys. Now, if you've got some big noob friends, share this video with them. It is bound to help them out as well. And of course, if you have any questions or comments or suggestions, please drop them in the comment section below. Once again, guys, thank you for watching. I hope you have a great day. I'm Defied, and happy gaming.